Good morning and greetings from Vienna. Ladies and gentlemen, dear colleagues, I would like to greet you all on behalf of the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs on this very special occasion of the meeting on improving public health through low-cost technology and GPS-tailored access to risk and resources. This meeting has a very important objective, as it serves as a pilot for establishing an open community framework for risk mitigation for people exposed to public health risks that show a special pattern and processes. As you are well aware, there are hundreds and hundreds of infectious diseases, some of which are among the most important causes of death in developing countries. Half of the world's population lives in affected areas. Malaria alone infects hundreds of million persons each year, killing almost 1 million. In recent years, information derived from Earth observation and meteorological satellites, in combination with GIS and GNSS, can increasingly be used to study disease epidemiology, enabling increased use of spatial analysis to identify the ecological, environmental, and other factors that contribute to the spread of vector-borne diseases by locating hotspots, monitoring disease patterns, and defining the areas that require disease control planning. Data collected by satellites and validated by fieldwork are extensively used for monitoring changes in disease patterns and identifying risk areas. Such data products, when incorporated in a geographic database, could be used to develop spatial models for combating infectious diseases by helping to predict high-risk areas before outbreaks occur. Application of teleepidemiology in public health is foreseen as a significant advancement to address the effects of global environmental changes, population growth, migration, land use changes, and natural disasters. Among these global determinants, climate change is predicted to play a key role in many health conditions of prime significance for public health. Dear colleagues, our Vienna-based Office for Outer Space Affairs, together with its partners, has been working to bring the benefits of space to Earth, to achieve development goals for the benefit of humankind. And the thematic area of global health, which includes teleepidemiology, telemedicine, telehealth, just to name a few, has very high priority both to our member states and to our office. In its activities, mostly carried on through its program on space applications, the office promotes application of space-based solutions to healthcare by providing capacity-building opportunities in specialized fields such as landscape epidemiology, distance learning on health subjects, tele-education of health professionals, and teleconsultations in isolated and remote areas. We also assist member states to use satellite remote sensing global positioning, GIS, and to support relevant health-related agencies to integrate ecological, environmental, and habitation data into the development of predictive models used for disease surveillance and control activities, as well as we promote long-term efforts in cross-disciplinary capacity building in the area of telehealth and teleepidemiology. Let me give you some examples of recent activities organized by UNUSA through the program on space applications and in cooperation with member states, specialized agencies, and intergovernmental organizations in the area of applications of space technologies to the global health. In 2008, we organized UN Burkina Faso, WHO, European Space Agency workshop on the use of space technology in telehealth to benefit of Africa. Same year, 2008, organized UN India European Space Agency regional workshop on using space technology for teleepidemiology to benefit Asia and the Pacific region. Next year, 2009, we organized workshop on applications of telehealth to service delivery in public health and environment, which took place in the Kingdom of Bhutan. Also in 2009, we organized UN symposium on space technology contribution to infectious surveillance and to the health-related Millennium Development Goals, which took place in Italy. In 2011, we had the UN Canada European Space Agency workshop on teleepidemiology contribution to public health actions in the context of climate change adaptation, which took place in Canada. Also in 2011, we had the UN Islamic Republic of Iran regional workshop on the use of space technology for human health improvement. In 2012, we had an international expert meeting on improving public health through space technology applications and open community approach, which took place in Bonn, Germany. In many instances, the above activities resulted in collaborative efforts and projects developed to support and enhance the use of space technology to prevent and control epidemics. Thus, for example, the Latin American Group on Teleepidemiology was established in 2005 as a part of the outcomes of the United Nations Argentina European Space Agency workshop on the use of space technology for human health, held in Cordoba, Argentina in 2005. The main objective of this group was to establish a regional alliance to facilitate the development and exchange of space technology applications in the public health sector for benefit of countries of Latin America and Caribbean. Among other initiatives in Latin America, the National Commission on Space Activities, CONAIA, of Argentina, with assistance of our office, has initiated the Advanced School for Training in Landscape Epidemiology. This two-week training program at Mario Gulich Institute for Advanced Space Studies in Cordoba, Argentina, comprises tutorial classes, the development of individual and institutional projects, and the development of regional initiatives. The third school session took place from May 27th to June 7th this year. Dear colleagues, talking about our activities, I cannot miss a reference to Unispace 3 and the important work done by Action Team 6. The third United Nations Conference on the Exploration and Peaceful Uses of Outer Space, so-called Unispace 3, was held in Vienna in 1999, and it recommended in its resolution entitled The Space Millennium, Vienna Declaration on Space and Human Development, that activities of the United Nations Program on Space Application should improve public health services by expanding and coordinating space-based services for telemedicine and for controlling infectious diseases. The Action Team on Public Health, so-called Action Team 6, was officially created in 2001 to follow up the implementation of this recommendation. The Action Team's mission was defined as to foster the implementation of telehealth for developing countries and to improve public health services by facilitating the application of space technologies in early warning of infectious diseases. Following this mandate, the Action Team addressed the following issues, which were initially proposed by the Office for Outer Space Affairs. Firstly, facilitating the development of national policies for utilizing broadband services and data in developing countries in order to support health surveillance and data acquisition for their purposes. Secondly, applying space-based data to develop an early warning mechanism capable of predicting public health threats and alerting authorities in a timely manner. And finally, facilitating the provision of or access to capacity building and training in the field of teleepidemiology. And actually this particular meeting was brought all of us together today is a follow-up to the work of Action Team 6. I'm really happy that Dr. Pascal Meschelli, who led the work of 86 for many years, is with us for this workshop and will share with us his experience and vision. Dear colleagues, I have no doubt that this workshop will present a unique opportunity for governmental agencies, research and academic centers, and non-governmental organizations to work together by sharing information and resources required for developing health risk management and response system. In this regard, I would like to acknowledge the input made by a number of people and organizations, without which this workshop would never come true. I'm talking about Ms. Anita Escher-Echevarria, Ambassador of El Salvador in Germany, Ms. Maria Isabel Rodriguez, Minister of Health of El Salvador, Professor Bert Niehaus, and the team from University of Koblenz-Landau, Dr. Pascal Meschelli, Public Health Agency of Canada, the team from Instituto Nacional de Salud of El Salvador, and all other participants of this meeting from Asia, Europe, Africa, and Latin America. May I conclude by giving you an assurance of the commitment of the Office for Outer Space Affairs in support of your efforts. Welcome once again, and please accept my best wishes for a productive workshop. Thank you very much for your kind attention.